How's everyone doing?
Good.
Play it loud.
Appreciate y'all guys coming out tonight and do the best I can to play some songs for you. Best I can play them regardless, but I'll do the best I can to play them right.
Was never gray. There was a time when I let you in.
Relationships, bad habits, things that just keep us from really realizing our potential. God, this song's called Nothing More.
Thank you.
just never stopped. I'm buried down a few below. I'm cutting ties now for the last time. Driving the rust in the final days. Don't sleep on me, the closure. It's you, my savior. Supposed to look like the portrait of perfection, the kind of clothes we're supposed to wear, the way we're supposed to talk, how much money we're supposed to have, who we're supposed to hang out with, and just all of these different types of things. And it, you know, we're all so different. And it's funny, we're all so different, yet, you know, God created us all in His image. And but we're not perfect per se. We're never going to be perfect until we reach heaven. It's just the way it is, you know. But God didn't create a flawed design. That's not it at all. But I think a lot of times we have a tendency to screw things up. But He loves us just the way we are. He created us the way we are. He loves us and wants to meet us right where we are, wherever that is. This song's called Best I Can.
Wasted so much time pretending I'm not lying about who I am.
guys. This next song is this one is pretty special to me, and it kind of, you know, some people ask me, like, do you ever get tired of playing the same songs over and over again? And I really don't. There's maybe one or two songs that Decipher Down does that I'm like, oh, okay, you know. Man, it's not even, I don't know, like, I always enjoy everything, full band. I don't know. This next song is one that hits me pretty good, though, still. You know, when I grew up, I remember being like 5 years old and going to church with my mom. That was my dad's mom, just a few times. And I didn't hear the whole message, but I heard enough to know that me and my family were kind of headed down a wrong path. You know, even at such a young age, you know, 5, 6 years old, I understood that part of it. I just didn't know how to fix it. And so it scared me. And I remember laying in bed at night, you know, crying and wondering, you know, how can I fix this? And in my 5-year-old mind, I thought to myself, me and my family are headed to the devil, and I don't know how to fix it. And I remember being 8 years old, and I remember playing at my buddy's house. We lived on this little gravel road, a little town called Pofftown, which is just west of North Carolina, which is, I still live in that area. And it's beautiful out there. We lived on this little gravel road, and I was up at my buddy's house playing just at the top of the hill, and 8 years old, my dad calls up there and he says, "Hey, can you send TJ home? We've got something we wanna tell him." And so I came home and I walk in, and my dad and my mom, they're sitting at the kitchen table, and across from them is my uncle, my dad's brother. He's sitting there with a Bible in his hand, and my dad says, "Hey, I just want you to know that we just gave our hearts to the Lord.
Amen.
And we're going to start going to church, and things are going to be different." And I remember being 8 years old thinking, you know, oh my gosh, this is such a relief. And this weight that was lifted off my shoulders, it was amazing. But, you know, then shortly after that, there was a period of time, I think, you know, a lot of times with addiction, things like that, drug abuse and alcohol, you don't realize there's a problem until you try to quit, kind of thing. I think also Satan tries really hard with people, and not to say that anybody's better than any other, but if somebody's on the right path, if they're you know, within God's will, and they're working toward that, you know, he really just tries to knock you down, and like he did in our family. And I remember, so shortly after we started going to church, we realized that there was a real drug problem within our family, and I wondered sometimes, you know, when's my dad going to come home, you know, today or tomorrow or whatever, and that type of thing. So I remember from 8 to 12, that's the kind of thing that I dealt with, and, you know, there was, you know, a lot of, you know, arguing and stuff like that in the house, and it was mainly stemming from that, or probably all stemming from that. So I saw firsthand as Satan tried to take the tool of addiction to rip my family apart, right? I saw through, you know, all the arguing and the just the hatred and everything, it was all from that, that playing out. But I also got to see the redemptive, restorative power of God.
Amen.
In my family. And so my parents have been married, so how old am I? 25. 30. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Hey, who laughed? Who laughed first? It wasn't the person that knows my real age. It wasn't you. Somebody laughed like it ain't true. Okay. Okay, so I'm not 25. So my parents have been married 36 years, okay? My dad's been a worship pastor for 23. God is good.
All the time.
And I say all that to say that, you know, there is delivering power through Jesus Christ. There is restorative power through Jesus Christ. I'm going to play this song for you. It's called Fading.
Yeah.
It starts with one time to fade in. Addiction slowly setting in. I drifted off into dismay.
eyes looking back at me. I can't even see your face. The pressure's closing in. It's taking me again. Weight is all that I can take. And every single day, a part of my soul is fading. And now, by letting go somehow, I'm shackled and unbound. I'm calling out your name, I'm fading. What I've become. It's like a force that's pulling you. This empty promise has the truth. Eyes looking back at me. I can't even see your face. The pressure's closing in. Taking me again. Weight is all that I can take. And every single day, a part of my soul is fading. And now, by letting go somehow, I'm shackled and unbound. I'm calling. Every single day, a part of my soul is fading. But now, I'm letting go somehow. I'm shackled and unbound. I'm calling out your name.
If you're a Decipher Down fan at all and you've ever owned a Crash CD or seen us in concert, I think you'd pick this song out.
Mm-hmm. try to buy some time and read the signs of the reason why. Every single time, like you're driving blind, can't make up my mind. I know I'm gonna find my way out, crash. You're going down without a sound, and I'll pass you up before I explode. Breaking into, I'll see it through. You will bring me down when I crash through you. I'll crash through you. So here we are right now. This is our time. So cross this line every single time. Like you're driving blind, can't make up my mind. I know I'm gonna find my way out, crash. You're going down without a sound, and I'll pass you up before I explode. Breaking into, I'll see it through. You will bring me down when I crash through you. Hear me out, I'm never backing down. Hear me out, I'm never backing down. Crash, you're going down without a sound, and I pass you up before I.
Since we recorded it, so let's not come out here and do it like this. Take me down to the river, wash the dirt from my hands. I've been traveling so long in this far-off land. Please, Father, forgive me, for I lost my way. Sin runs through my body, it's poison in my veins. Pull me up.
that song again.
Yeah.
I should have known from the start, oh, I couldn't do it alone. Yes, I tried and tried so hard, yeah, to make this place my home. So come redemption, come set me free. Oh, help me water now, and come get me.
Oh,
Now I'm so tired that I can't find any more. It feels as though I've turned into my own door. I feel so hard, hoping that you care. But then I turn and find you
ago for an album called Scarecrow, and this song is really just about that kind of pew clenching moment. It's called Bleeding Lies.
Stop me from being a bootleg love. smallest untruths are often those left untold. What can I do in reaping these tales I sow? Mind's closing in, and I won't pretend I'm fine. If this bleeding is pain, then Lord, put me under the
pleasing the Father. And, you know, so many times I feel like a lot of people, we've said a prayer that, you know, for the Lord to come in our hearts, we've said, please, you know, Lord, forgive me my sins. Lord, you know, I repent, come into my heart, and, you know, now I'm a believer, you know, in Jesus' name, amen. And we set that to the side, and that's kind of sometimes the end of that. And, but God has so much more for us. And I think a lot of times, you know, I was reading a book called, I stopped saying that I read a book because I didn't really read the whole thing. So I thought just now, in the middle of saying that, I thought, you know, I'm going to say I was reading a book. As the words were coming out of my mouth, it was like, say that because that's the truth. So I didn't read the whole thing, but I'd like to because it's a really good book. It's called The Purpose-Driven Life.
Yeah.
It's a great book. And it really, in this one part, is talking about what true worship is. And is that, you know, going to church and for a few songs every Sunday, or is it, you know, is it just a continuous thinking on the things of Christ and thanking God for, you know, everyday occurrences, if you will, or just everyday things that we, you know, sometimes take for granted so much. And really, what it came down to is it's just constant communication with Him. And I feel like a lot of times, you know, with our mother and our father, our wives, our husbands, boyfriends, girlfriends, if you guys are into that sort of thing, you know, we want to make them proud of us. We want them to be proud of us, and we want them to be happy and pleased with what we do. And you know, just as with our, you know, our physical parents or our wives or husbands, we all feel that way also about our Heavenly Father. And I feel like a lot of times that relationship doesn't seem as real to us because there's such a lack of communication. And I feel like if we would just, you know, just have open dialogue with God. I mean, you know, what's knowing how to pray? What is that? You know? We just talk to God, man. That's all it's about. It's like, you don't have to be some, you know, amazing, you know, theologian on some pedestal who knows, you know, some crazy awesome prayer and these and thous and all that stuff. It's just, hey God, man, I love you. Thank you. Thank you for another beautiful day. And I think the more that we're in communication with Him, the more contact we have with Him, the more He becomes tangible to us, the more real He is to us, the more we want to please Him, the more we want His desires to be our desires. And it's not a thing about surrendering anymore, because it's what, not only what, you know, what does He want for our lives, but it's what we want for our lives. This song's called Just to Please You.
Oh,
wonder what my future holds for me and you. Yeah. Just to please you, Father, is my one desire.
With us, and we had this exact same stand that had a whole bunch of electric guitars in it, and then this one guitar that I've had since I was 21. So it's been all over the country, and I'm doing that. And I saw him shoving in there one day in the stand. And it hit everything on the way in, including the front, the bridges on the front of the other guitars. I told him if he hit my guitar, he said, "It's just a guitar, man." I said, "Slow down, man." I said, "It's just a guitar.
It's got a name."
It's got a name. I told him, I said, "I'll tell you something, my dad bought me that guitar. It's my first really nice acoustic guitar. And if you do that again, I got Greyhound with your name on it." I'm really a nice person to work for. I really am, I promise. And he's a good dude. I love the guy. I guess I didn't love him as much as I did my guitar. all flesh. So, this next song would really... about rolling up our sleeves and not worrying so much about, you know, a lot of times we worry so much about Sunday, we forget about the rest of our lives, we forget about the rest of our influence throughout the week. And even me, as much as I rehearse for this, sometimes you can take it, sometimes you can't, but as much as I rehearse to get on stage and do what I do, this is the most important part of what I do. It's, you know, it's very fun. It's way funner than driving. This is the most important part. You know? I believe one-on-one conversations with people before and after shows is really, and that's just this. You know, still there's times that I interact with people at gas stations and restaurants and people's homes who are so awesome to let us come and stay like Cindy and Dan. And, you know, a lot of times we have conversations where, you know, we're ministering to one another, and it's not even just about that, but just living a life of servitude. And if all we worry about is Sunday morning or our time in the spotlight and stuff like that, you know, what are we really doing?
That's right.
So this song really is not even talking about telling people about Jesus and stuff like that. It's really just about showing people the love of God, because we don't have to cram that down anybody's throat. We really don't. I think it's more important to have an outward manifestation than that in our actions than anything else. This song's called Walk Love.
Keep what I am all around, never ever see the act of love. World's just on and up. say these things when I'm the one that lives this way. Cause I don't wanna talk life long, don't seem the same. So Lord, give me the words to speak the truth so we can learn today. Yeah. Throughout life you've used the worst, the best, the strongest and the weak. Not only you can use me, but sometimes I feel so ashamed before the ones you use me to lead. I feel I'm not who I should be. Yeah. It's hard to say these things when I'm the one that lives this way. Cause I don't want to talk life, my heart don't seem the same. So Lord, give me the words to speak the truth so we can learn. Tomorrow's just another day, the pain I promised anyway. So I'll push my cares aside and do just what you asked me for. I don't want to talk love if my heart don't seem the same. So Lord, give me the words to speak the truth so we can learn today. Yeah. People gather all around waiting for a word from up above.
Some people might get mad and say, I can't believe you're going to follow that up with this right here.
When she cries through the night, Tommy whispers, Baby, it's okay. Someday, you said we gotta hold on to what we've got. It doesn't make a difference if we make it or not. We got each other, and that's a lot for love. Just give it a shot.
As smooth as possible and least amount of times possible. Lost an amazing musician.
Hey.
My son is being a goober in the playroom back there. Oh well.
Did anyone actually see that song live?
I saw it live in 2009.
Did you? Oh, okay.
But that's when John was going like this with his mic to the crowd and not going for it.
That's awesome. Someone,
I wish I saw
it
live.
You ain't even born.
We lost a great musician about a year and a half ago. Somebody who I study his voice all the time, watched every YouTube video, and I think as musicians, a lot of us have somebody like that, whether it's, you know, Eddie Van Halen, or whether it's like me, Chris Cornell, or it's, you know, we all have somebody who we kind of tap into and that we really identify with, if not lyrically, stylistically, or something that we just really, you know, something that they have that really just pulls you in. And that's the way it was with me. And so it's been tough to, it was a super tough time for me, as was with a lot of other people. You know, it's funny, like, I remember this, and this doesn't, I mean, I don't know why I'm saying this, but I know that I didn't get it when, like, Dale Earnhardt died. And the reason I use him as an example is because I'm from Winston-Salem. He's from Wakanapolis, that area, just south of me. And there were, you know, just huge NASCAR fans in my area. And it devastated a lot of people, and I didn't get it as much because I wasn't in that scene. I wasn't in the circuit. I didn't watch it as much. And when this happened, I understood at that point. And you know, it was a little different. He took his life. He took his own life. And, you know, if anybody is ever having any kind of thoughts like that, any kind of feelings of doubt and just, you know, worthlessness, or just like there's no light at the end of the tunnel, man, speak up. You know, because The thing is, there's people who love you, and there's people who want to help you to see you through that and help you come out on the other side a better person. That old saying they say is a temporary solution, or a permanent solution to a temporary problem, is just very true. That sounds cliche, but it's very true. This song's called Fell in Blackface.
Show my change. Yeah.
We're down.
So if you know these last few songs, I want to hear you guys sing along with me.
Thank you.
Make sure that you get a delicious cup of coffee. I'm going to try to get two because I'm driving 5 hours to get home tonight. maybe a couple extra shots in there. Maybe what they call it, a red eye or something like that. Yes, a couple of like triple shots. So anyway, though, God loves you. I love you. And please hang around for a little while. I'll come down here from here in just a few minutes. Thank you, guys.